Welcome to the Nanjing Olympic Sports Center Natatorium, the aquatic center for the second Summer Youth Olympic Games. This is the eighth session of the swimming competition in these quadrennial games, and certainly some intriguing finals and semi-finals are upon us as day four will draw to a conclusion. Italy won four gold medals over the past 2 days of competition, but the People's Republic of China remain the only country to have won gold medals on every day of the competition so far. Will that trend continue? Or can other nations indeed continue to augment their medal haul, particularly gold medals, with team or individual displays on this final session of day four in the pool? What a session awaits as Christian Springer, alongside world 100-meter breaststroke champion, takes us through what is particularly a day of sprints in the pool, Christian, including the men's 50 free, women's 50 fly, and the men's 50 fly semis, plus the men's 50 backstroke final.
Well, absolutely, it's going to be a hell of a night. Starting off with that men's 50 free, we're going to see the man, Yu Hexin, could be the first junior to go sub 22 seconds.
Just remarkable time, absolutely remarkable time. And we'll start off with the men's 50 meter freestyle final. World junior silver medalist Dylan Carter has an opportunity to go in lane three for Trinidad and Tobago, but he is alongside Yu Hexin, the 18-year-old, taking gold in the 4x100 freestyle relay. Can the Chinese swimmer, and indeed the Trinidad and Tobago swimmer, keep off the brilliance of the Brazilian de Santana as well? The judges, the technical officials as well, being introduced. Jose de Jesus is the men's referee, while Daphne Bird is the women's referee. The starters will be introduced momentarily. Carl Sorensen, men's starter, and the women's starter, Yambe. Seven finals in the eighth session of the swimming competition of these Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games. That's some phenomenal sprint swims to be expected in the pool. These are the swimmers who will be doing duty as they attempt to win the three medals on offer. Gold, silver, and bronze. For the men's 50 meter freestyle. It's one length, only 50 meters. So much depends on the start. Two great British swimmers go in lanes one and two alongside one another, both gold medalists in the men's 4x100 freestyle relay. Miles Monroe, the 18-year-old, goes in lane one, while the 17-year-old Duncan Scott goes in two. From Trinidad and Tobago, the flag bearer and world junior silver medalist. This is the man that posted the quickest time and set to go sub 22 seconds in the final, Yu Hexin of China. Matheus, Paulo de Santana of Brazil, saw the medal already in these championships, sub 48 seconds in the 100 free in the relay to take Brazil into medal contention in the first place. Going in sixth for Poland is Jan Holub. Damian Bierling out in lane seven for Germany. Bronze in the 200 free. And a relay silver for Alessandro Abori, who goes in lane eight.
Well, it's going to be in the center of the pool here. We've got three of the best juniors in the world, three of the fastest juniors ever, and it's going to be one hell of a race.
I just wonder if this is going to be... De Santana over 100 is superb. But has he got the speed in the pool to make it count on the 50? I think gold is going to be won between Carter and Yu. Carter's got the ability, but Yu is inspired. Men's 50-meter freestyle, decent start for Yu Ishin, but Carter got off to the best possible start, but Yu is so superb in the pool. Will he go sub 22 seconds? That really is the race. The real test for Carter. Carter and Yu going side by side, but on the stroke, Yu is in front. Can he go below 22 seconds? That really is the marker. It's going to be gold for the People's Republic of China. Yu will take it. Will Carter give and claim the silver? He doesn't. De Santana's got it. It was the center lanes, but what a swim. 22 dead is the time. We'll wait to see it ratified. He was expecting to go sub 22, but by the time he hit his stroke, he was an inch or two behind Carter off the starting block. But once he got into his stroke, it was superb.
Oh, he was an absolute machine in that final 20 meters. He really made sure that he was the dominant form, and that was impressive. 22.00, that's as close as you get. And wow, finish on a great stroke too.
Looking to become the first junior to go sub 22 in the men's 53. He hasn't gone sub 22, but he missed it by 1/100th of a second. 22 dead. Phenomenal swim. He takes gold for the People's Republic of China. China's fifth gold medal in the pool. To the semi-final, first of two, with his 50-meter backstroke. There's some intriguing finals to come. It's time for a little semi-final. By little, I mean, 50 meters. The backstroke, which sees two New Zealanders going in separate semi-finals. Both hoping for a medal. One is expected to medal, another will be hoping to medal. Going in lane one, though, for Poland in the first of the semi-finals, Nicola Petrica. Pauline Mayu of France goes in two. Eleni Kutsuveli goes in three for Greece. Well, for Canada, Daniel Hannes goes in four. Now, already a silver medal in the 100. She missed out on gold by 1/100th of a second. Jessica Fuller-Love of Great Britain goes in five. From New Zealand, the thoroughly impressive 14-year-old Bobby Gishard, who claimed bronze over the 100, goes in six. Mandy Felbinder of Germany goes in seven. And Spain's Nora Yus Fernandez goes in lane eight.
Well, there's some real talent in this first semi-final. I look forward to seeing how the battle plays out between Daniel Hannes from Canada and Jessica Fuller-Love. Center lanes, and look out for, as we said, the 14-year-old Bobby Gishard.
First semi-final in the women's 50-meter backstroke, and getting off to a very good start. Jessica Fuller-Love of Great Britain uses her underwater so well, has come up a head length ahead of anybody else, but swimming alongside her on the inside is Daniel Hannes, who's going along very nicely indeed. Going in lane four, the swimmers almost from lanes one to five, almost up alongside one another, but certainly drawing alongside one another now. It's Daniel Hannes and Jessica Fuller-Love. Who's going to take it to the line? Hannes is going to take it, I think. It looks to be just ahead of Fuller-Love, and it is Hannes who touches first ahead of Fuller-Love, with Gishard doing enough to claim third, the 14-year-old Bobby Gishard. It's about the times they post in the semi-finals, of course, as to who advances to the final, the top eight. From the semi-finals, it's about posting a really decent time. Sub 29 seconds, I would imagine, is going to easily claim a place in the top eight.
Well, it was a good swim from Hannes, but I felt that Jessica Fuller-Love stuck to that lane rope in that last 10 meters and really hindered her ability. So she's going to have to look at that, fix that finish up.
Straighten that up, could very well do a little damage come the final. Hannes, Fuller-Love and Gishard. First two swimmers, sub 29 seconds. Kutsuveli. We have to wait to see the results of the second semi-final. Going going in the second semi-final of the women's 50-meter backstroke. We've got an interesting collection of swimmers. Carla Smitty, the first swimmer from the United States of America to claim the gold medal at these championships when she won the women's 100-meter backstroke, will go. The lane draws, though, going in lane one for the Ukraine is Irina Glavnyk. Brazil's Natalia De Lucas goes in two. From the United States of America, the incredibly powerful Clara Smitty goes in three. The world junior champion over this distance, 14-year-old of Samoan heritage from New Zealand, hailing from Auckland. She goes in four. Dutch sprinter Maaike de Vaart goes in five. Well, the Czech Republic's impressive youngster, another 15-year-old, Teresa Grusova, goes in six. Gold medalist and the first female individual gold medal winner at these championships, which won the 200 individual medley, Vien Nguyen Tiam, goes in seven, while Irina Prikhodko of Russia goes in eight.
Well, Hannes has set the pace with a 28.8. Let's see a response from Gabriel Famasuli, who's arguably the favorite in this event.
She can certainly go low 28. And it all depends on the start, though. Again, it's all about getting away so quickly. When it comes to the difference of 0.2 of a second at the end of the race, that can come down to a slow reaction time. Difference between 0.5 and 0.7 off the starting block. Second semi-final of the women's backstroke, and a decent start for Famasuli. Unfortunately, all New Zealander going strong, but making her underwater count. She's one of the first to rise, though. Going in five is Maaike de Vaart of the Netherlands, expected to take it out really hard indeed. And in fact, alongside de Vaart as well, for a short while, it looked like Rusev was finding her stride. Tara Smitty is leaving it a little late, but she is coming back slowly but surely. Going in two is De Lucas, but ultimately, I think it is going to be Famasuli of New Zealand who is going to take it to the wall with de Vaart. Challenging her for the top spot. Who's going to touch first? It is Famasuli ahead of de Vaart, with Smitty holding on for the third place finish. Down to the times, though. And, a 28.78, fastest qualifier. She'll have lane four for the final.
Well, she's swimming well, but I think she's getting a bit of sluggish off that start. And for that final, it's going to be incredibly important for her to explode off that entry. But look, Maaike de Vaart from the Netherlands looked very good then. She's got to up her ante in that swim, and she could have the goal.
It just manages to reach the wall first. De Vaart is certainly in there for medal contention, especially if she can get inspired by the swimmer around her outside. Only 0.1 of a second separating the two. The only two sub-29 in the second semi-final. The eight swimmers who advanced to the final, New Zealand's junior world champion, Famasuli, qualifies along with compatriot Bobby Yishan for the final. Daniel Hannes, Maaike de Vaart, Jessica Fullerlam, Clara Smitty, Kutsaveli of Greece, and Pogorko of Russia round out the lanes. This is the start list for the men's 200 meter breaststroke final. And some fine talent indeed. Ippei Watanabe will fancy his chances over the longer distance in the breaststroke. He'll go in six. Pilger of Germany will be looking for greater success as well in the pool. And he goes in lane five. That's Anton Chupkov, already a breaststroke champion. Over the 100, he'll go in three. And the Battle Deluxe awaits. That's German Pilger. Going in lane one, though, Andreas Emanuel de Kirosh-Mikosh. Looking for greater success ahead of the next senior Summer Olympic Games in Rio de Janeiro in 2 years' time. Daniel Horvats of Hungary goes in two. Has a classical stroke about him. Anton Chupkov of Russia, the 17-year-old 100-meter breaststroke champion, goes in three. Carlos CLAVERIE, bronze in the men's 100 breaststroke, goes in four. Silver medalist from that 100 breaststroke, and also a bronze medalist in the 4x103 relay. Max Pilger goes in five. Ippei Watanabe will fancy himself over this longer distance. He comes into his own in the second 100. Could be a medal contender. Tsai Bingrong goes in 7 for Chinese Taipei. while South Africa's Jared Kraus goes in lane 8.
Chupkov's certainly going to be chasing that double in this event, but the response from Watanabe could be very, very skillful. And I tell you what, he's got a great technique. These two both have very efficient strokes, so let's see a good battle between 3 and 6, but obviously the center lanes, it's going to be anyone's game.
You've got to consider the 100-meter medalist Chupkov, Pilger, Clavery. They're going 3, 5, and 4, respectively. The final of the men's 200-meter breaststroke is underway with Anton Chupkov of Russia going in 3, spending an age under the water and coming up decently, but at the moment it looks to be Pilger of Germany going along very strong. He does take it out pretty hard. Clavery's looking to settle into his own, and once he finds a rhythm, looks rather impressive in the pool. But at the moment, not much separating any of these swimmers. It'll come, particularly the third and fourth legs.
Well, the first 50 to 200 is not generally where you see the winner. And these guys just getting into their stroke now. They're really going to get relaxed. And you can't make a move too early because you don't want to expend that energy. If you go too early, too hard, it's all over. But at the moment, I'm really liking how Watanabe's looking. But don't discount Chupkov.
So we're looking at a few particularly impressive youngsters looking to go. Ippei Watanabe is a 2.11 swimmer over this distance at his best. In fact, over the last 2 years, has swum the fastest time. But he is not the swimmer to take it at the 100 split. CLAVERIE of Venezuela ahead of Watanabe, who will come into his own over the second 100 of this race, the back end of this race. Horvat has got a decent stroke when he's getting into it, but he might have left it just a little too long. He's going in lane 2, he's slowly making up ground. This is coming up over the shoulder of Chupkov, the 100-meter champion. He doesn't look to be in genuine contention for a gold, but will be pushing hard, particularly when he senses that he's got Horvat coming up over his right shoulder. Watanabe is looking good, and Clavery is looking well positioned as well. Turns with 50 to go, and Watanabe's got a little work to do here as Clavery comes off the wall quite brilliantly.
Well, Clavery's looking very good, but as I say that, the two guys, the challenge from Chupkov is coming from Russia, and this could be a very, very strong finish from Horvat from Hungary.
Well, Horvat is putting himself into medal contention, but it is Japan's Watanabe. Said he would finish strong. He's a 2.11 swimmer over this distance. So is Horvat. But Watanabe and Horvat are really finishing particularly strong here. Chupkov could go to the line. Could it be CLAVERIE? It's CLAVERIE who claims another medal. It's a silver, though. It is Watanabe of Japan. He claims Japan's first swimming gold medal of Nanjing 2014. Ippei Watanabe at 2.11.31. That is his best over the last year as well.
Well, the race was certainly won in that last 15 meters of this game, and obviously getting into that rhythm was so important. I've got to give it to CLAVERIE, though. He went out strong, and that's very admirable. But Watanabe, that last 20, magical.
Well, he turned at the turn. He touched 0.57 behind. His turn was poor. By the time he actually broke water after the turn, he had to catch up a full second, and he did. Overturned it quite brilliantly, and the way he came home,
well, by far the fastest of the last 50, so he certainly earned that gold.
Going in lane 6, Ippei Watanabe is the champion in the men's 200 meter breaststroke over CLAVERIE of Venezuela, who now has silver to go with his bronze from the 100, and Chupkov of Russia, gold in the 100. He takes bronze in the 2. Sense of expectation from this partisan home crowd at the Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games on not only Yu Heixin, but indeed on the Chinese swimmers in totality. Now, after helping China to gold in the 4x100 freestyle relay, Yu Heixin, in his specialist event, the men's 50 freestyle, was expected to claim gold. He was up against the junior world silver medalist Dylan Carter, and up against an incredibly strong Matheus de Santana of Brazil. Ultimately, though, those three would finish 1, 2, 3 that you would claim gold. This is the men's 50-meter freestyle victory ceremony. Here are the medalists in the men's 50-meter freestyle. Another proud moment for this young man, 18-year-old Yu Heshid. Another thoroughly impressive swim. Desperate to go under the 22-second mark. And he finished 22 seconds dead. Nicole Hivert of Aruba, International Olympic Committee member, will be handing out the respective medals. Maybe a sense that he is a better swimmer, but on the night he was beaten by two men who put in superb efforts in the pool. Dylan Carter, junior silver medalist, picks up Trinidad and Tobago's first swimming medal of Nanjing 2014. It's bronze. He has a chance to claim silver or gold in the men's 50 meter fly before this competition closes. But for now, he will settle for the bronze medal. And no disgrace in making the podium. Well, after a silver in the relay, he swam that sub 48 second 100 leg to take Brazil into medal contention. Help them to that silver. 18-year-old Matheus de Santana of Brazil claims silver over the shorter distance, the men's 50 freestyle. Another impressive swim. He was closing fast. And one off the top spot. But a delighted swimmer who will look forward to swimming in the Olympic Games in his home nation in 2 years' time. But a championship-winning swim from a man who is a champion again. He's tasted success. Looking to become the first junior to ever go under 22 seconds over this distance. Men's 50 freestyle. He finished 22 seconds dead. But an incredibly impressive swim after leaving it just a little late off the starting block. Not the fastest reaction time. If he tightens that up, what he does in the pool will render him virtually unbeatable over this distance as a junior. And now we'll have to be competitive in the senior ranks. But China have their fifth swimming gold medal. And now for the national anthem of the host nation. the delighted applause from the partisan home crowd. Three proud men displaying their medals. And China, the champions once more. Yu Hexin invites the Brazilian and Trinidad and Tobago medal winners, silver and bronze, up onto the top rung. They'll be celebrated as champions in their own right, but Yu Hexin, so impressive.
That's right, I mean, he was really impressive. He was an absolute machine once he got going, and I think between these two, or these three even, we could see a great 100 battle coming up later in the competition.
People's Republic of China with the first gold. This is the eighth session of the swinging competition of Nanjing 2014. Day four gets underway. Seven finals to have already been decided. And the first medal to the host nation. People's Republic of China's fourth successive day of winning medals. Their fifth overall. The start list for the women's 50-meter fly final, another sprint event in which several incredibly competitive swimmers will go. NASRETDINOVA, Russia, will go in four, looking for her first gold medal. Nastja GOVEJSEK, impressive in the semi-final. Can she improve and claim a gold? Svenja STOFFEL looked good. Gilagi, already a gold medal winner. Brianna Throstel, three bronze medals. Many talented young swimmers aiming for that top spot. These are the eight competitors who will do battle. Some of those three medals, gold, silver, and bronze. Two finals already concluded. Both men's finals. This is the first final for women. And the eighth session of the swimming competition. Giovanna Tominic Diamante of Brazil goes in lane one. Elise Ney Sorsen, 16 years old, goes in lane two of the Scandinavian nation. Australia's Brianna Throstel took bronze in the women's 200 fly. Three bronze medals in total, goes for Australia in three. Rozaliya NASRETDINOVA, 17-year-old Russian, goes in four. Alongside of those, Slovenian swimmer, very strong. Always smiling, 17-year-old Nastja GOVEJSEK. Switzerland's 17-year-old Svenja STOFFEL goes in six. The 200 fly gold medalist from Hungary, Liliana Szilagyi, goes in seven. And in lane eight, Slovakia's 16-year-old Barbara Misendova.
Well, this is a very tough race to call. Obviously, with Navistrova in from Russia in lane four and GOVEJSEK in lane five, it's going to be tough, and I think STOFFEL is looking great. Throstel coming into her own as well. Look, this race is going to come down to the wire.
Who wants it most? Who is as prepared as any other? One length of this Olympic pool. The women's 50-meter fly is underway, and a phenomenal start for NASRETDINOVA, going for Russia in four, and already off to such an impressive lead out in the pink cap. Going very strong on her inside, though, is Brianna Throstel, but has she got too much work to do on the outside, though? GOVEJSEK is settled into a fine stroke, but it's in lane six where the real movement is taking place. Switzerland STOFFEL is coming up hard in lane six. Can NASRETDINOVA hold on for Russia? NASRETDINOVA on the stroke, into the wall. She goes ahead of STOFFEL of Switzerland. Throstel misses out as GOVEJSEK manages to sneak up and pip her to the bronze medal. But Rozaliya NASRETDINOVA, the one lap one length of this Olympic pool, smashes into the wall just ahead of Svenja Stoffel of Switzerland and Slovenia's Govejsek.
Well, she took complete control of that race from the get-go, and there was no catching this girl. And if you look back towards the end of that race, Nastja finished on the perfect stroke. Stoffel had to sort of commit to a final stroke that she wasn't quite comfortable with, and with that, she fell 0.4 from the goal.
And Throttle, who he thought was going to settle for the bronze, fourth of the championships, was pipped by 0.02 of a second by Govejsek, who claims bronze. Stoffel takes silver. NASRETDINOVA, her first individual goal, 26-26 to claim the women's 50 fly. Swiss support, athletes, technical team, and only two square flags in the world, Switzerland. And for one sprint final, now to the men's 50 meter backstroke, the eight protagonists in this incredibly well set up final. Just over half a second separate the fastest and the slowest of these qualifiers. That's how tight this final is likely to be. They could be separated by less than half a second from finishes 1 to 8. But let's introduce the athletes as they line up for their lane draws. Ukraine's Andrei Kopchov goes in lane 1, still only 15 years old. What an experience it'll be. Oh, this young step alongside him, though, 16-year-old Philip Chopin. Came to Nanjing as a world junior champion, a world junior record holder of 100. He failed to medal. He needs this. Apostolos Christou goes in 3. Simone Sabbioni, gold medalist in the men's 100 backstroke, who swims alongside the gold medalist in the women, the men's 100 back, Evgeny RYLOV, and Simone Sabbioni dead heated for the gold in that 100 back. Vitor Nascimento of Brazil goes in 6, while the Dutch swimmer, 18-year-old Loan Bam, goes in 7. Looked good in the men's 100 back, but failed to make the final. And then Romania's Robert Klinter goes in 8. The Christian, a battle expected between Sabbioni and RYLOV. Dead heat over the 100.
Well, after seeing that 100 metres, we got very excited about what the outcome would be for this 50 metres. Sabbioni looks great. RYLOV looking very strong. He was the fastest out in that 100 metres, so will he have the front end? But then, CHRISTOU, you know, he's an outside chance. He's obviously didn't quite medal in the 100, but he's a great backstroker.
Well, he set a junior world record over 100 within a month of coming to China, yet failed to medal in the 100. He's expecting a medal here. Will it be gold? Off to a very slow start with Sabbioni of Italy, but RYLOV got off to a superb start. CHRISTOU, though, looks pretty good for Greece as well as he gets into his stroke nice and early. And at the moment, it is lanes 3 and 5 who are leading it out. It is CHRISTOU and RYLOV. Sabbioni, what's he got in the pool? He's coming into his own stroke and, in fact, just edging up into the middle. It looks like the middle. The medalists have been decided already. RYLOV looking to extend it now. RYLOV will take it to the line. The Russian is going to win it. RYLOV ahead of CHRISTOU. Sabbioni will finish third for Italy. And a real sense of revenge in his own right for RYLOV. He's claimed the double, the men's 50, to go with the gold he won in the men's 100 backstroke. And he will claim now that he is the best junior backstroker.
Well, that was very impressive. He made his move with 25 to go, and he really got going. And all credit to CHRISTOU as well for taking out the silver medal. That was an impressive swim. And Sabbioni obviously finishing with the bronze.
Well, he didn't have the best of starts, Sabbioni. He looked to be edging through the center. And this is what it means to RYLOV. That immense celebration, the absolute delight, the raw emotion of it all. This was expected to be tight, and in the end, he did it fairly comfortably by over a second, separating him and Klopchov, who finished in 8th position. RYLOV, the gold medalist, CHRISTOU takes silver. The women's 100-meter breaststroke now, where Julia Villas gets an opportunity to improve on her silver medal in the 50 breast. But this possibly a race that will have been decided before the swimmers even take to the pool. The eight swimmers making their way out now to the starting blocks. Two lengths of the breaststroke. Some impressive young swimmers who've really made waves, if you'll pardon the pun, in this Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games so far. The second Summer Youth Olympic Games, like the maiden edition in 2010, have served up some phenomenal swimmers, phenomenal swimming talent. Julia Villers of Germany goes in one for Germany, silver in the 50 breast. She wants to medal again in the 100. Alongside her, though, Dana Sebastian. She's made the final of every event she's entered. She hasn't got a medal yet in Nanjing. She goes in two. Anastasiya Malyavina of Ukraine goes in three for the 16-year-old. This is a big final for her. With gold in the 50 breaststroke, the 17-year-old world and Olympic champion, the world record holder over this distance, goes in four. He Yun of China, gold in the 4x100 medley relay for the host nation, goes in five. Silja Konsakoski of Finland, her chance to shine after missing the 50 breaststroke final, goes in six. Georgina Evans of Great Britain, the silver medalist in the relay. He's here for the relays, the 50, 100 and 200 breaststroke events, goes in seven. And Anna Stankovic of Hungary, who won bronze in the women's 50 breaststroke, goes in lane eight. The International Olympic Committee president, Thomas Bach, sitting alongside two of the greatest swimmers of their generation, both from Africa, Chandler Klo of South Africa, Kirsty Coventry of Zimbabwe. Is this, Christian, fair to ask who will win the silver and bronze? And we discuss it from there. The women's 100-meter breaststroke, and the only swimmer in the world who can go 104 over this distance. Well, Milutyte, she's taking it out hard, but again, she will have the luxury of deciding whether or not she's going to push it to the line. She is the gold medalist.
Well, it's very hard not to watch her, and that technique is almost flawless. She's getting every bit of inch out of that stroke and coming into the wall with 30.4. I mean, that's a great 50 on its own.
Well, Heyun is being pulled along by one of the greatest swimmers the world has seen in recent years. She dominates her generation. She's the world champion. She's the Olympic champion. And it's hard to believe that she will only finish her A-levels in the year that Rio hosts the Olympic Games. She will only be 19 at the time of the Olympics in Rio de Janeiro. She's going to come home for the gold. She's already starting to just get into her stroke now. But Ruta Milutytė of Lithuania is going to take her second gold medal of these championships. Who's up for the silver, though? It looks to be on her outside. Heyun of China will claim the silver. And Malyavina touches for the bronze. A very impressive swim from the 16-year-old Ukrainian. But what a swim from Ruta Milutytė again, a 105.39. It's nowhere near her personal best, but she wasn't tested genuinely by the swimmers around her. All she needed to do was swim the race. She knew she was guaranteed gold. And as much as we make light of her swimming ability, we cannot overstate just how good a swimmer she is.
Well, not only is she great at swimming breaststroke, but she's got the skills. She's got that great start. She's got an incredible turn. And she really nails the streamline at every opportunity. So, you know, she's really got the full package.
Well, for Heyun as well, a 108 swimmer at her very best, to knock off nearly a second of her personal best, gives you an idea of the effort she was putting into the pool. She takes silver for the host nation, while Yavina of the Ukraine gets another medal for the Ukraine after Romanchuk started off so brilliantly for Ukraine. The men's 200-meter breaststroke was expected to be a particularly intense affair between the medalists in the men's 100 breaststroke, CHUPKOV, Pilger, CLAVERIE, and indeed the outside chance, but the man who was possibly strongest over the 200, the 211 swimmer coming into this final, Ippei Watanabe of Japan. In the end, the Japanese swimmer first to the wall in a thoroughly impressive 211.31. Huge celebration. Japan and their first swimming gold medal of Nanjing 2014. This is the victory ceremony then for the men's 200 meter breaststroke. The medalists for the men's 200 meter breaststroke. Enormous moment for Ippei Watanabe. Most appropriate that Japanese IOC member, Mr. Tomikaze Takeda, will present the gold medal to his compatriot, Ippei Watanabe. The bronze medalist was the men's 100 meter breaststroke champion, 17-year-old Russian Anton CHUPKOV. He can be particularly proud of that effort.
The time has run a little bit too late in the end, but to get a bronze, still an impressive effort.
He has his gold. Came in the 100, in the 2, just couldn't keep up with Watanabe's close. And CHUPKOV is the bronze medalist. But a man who did go one better, a bronze medalist in the men's 100 breaststroke, Carlos CLAVERIE of Venezuela. A fine stroke, and he really settles into his own race. He doesn't have his race dictated by the swimmers around him, and I think that's what's most impressive. He has a sense of the psychological spirit that you need to succeed.
Well, he took it out, he did it his way, and ultimately that's what got him the medal in the end, and he'll be very happy with a 2.11 swim.
2.11 swim. He has bronze and silver in the men's 100 and 200 breaststroke events, respectively. But perhaps most appropriate, Japan's 17-year-old Ippei Watanabe, hailing from a country that's produced possibly the greatest breaststroker of them all.
Well, that's it. We can learn so much from Kasuke Kitajima. He's done some of the greatest feats in the world. But, you know, the generation of breaststrokers coming out of Japan is simply superb.
Inspired mostly by Kitajima, as is this man, Ippei Watanabe. Japan's first gold medal of Nanjing 2014 in the pool. He is the champion of the men's 200 meter breaststroke. Now for the national anthem of Japan. proud young man. And so promising as well that all three of these medalists are not among the top age group athletes at these games. Still barely 17 years old, all three, Chupkov, CLAVERIE and Watanabe. So it's a promising future for the men's breaststroke. They are the three top swimmers over this distance. As a breaststroker, Christian, what talent awaits in the pool, possibly challenging yourself and a few others in the years ahead?
Well, it's a little bit scary, but you know, there's a lot of talent coming out from these youth games, and specifically breaststroke. You know, the technique is what I'm seeing becoming more and more impressive in these younger athletes, and I think that is a contributor to some of the things like watching the big names and learning from them.
A race that really could have gone any way. One length of the Olympic pool, the women's 50-meter butterfly. Only one of possibly five swimmers could have even come to the wall first, but a swimmer that stuck around up to a certain extent in the semi-finals in Rozaliya NASRETDINOVA of Russia had a superb start and looked to hold that advantage all the way to the wall. She did. And claimed yet another gold medal for Russia in the pool. And what is turning out to be a most impressive display in Session 8 for the Russian Federation. This is the victory ceremony of the women's 50-meter butterfly. Three medalists from the women's 50-meter fly. The champion from Russia, Rozaliya NASRETDINOVA. National Olympic Committee member from Aruba, Nicole Hubert, we'll hand over the medals to the three young women. Bronze medalist in the women's 50-meter butterfly from Slovenia, Nastja GOVEJSEK. She worked it hard, and this is her result. She's a medalist at the Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games. Thank you. beautiful smile and a sense that she's really chuffed with the bronze medal. Took it out so hard in the semi-final. Come the final, she went hard, but it was a finish that was most impressive. Guaranteed her the silver. Switzerland, Svenja Stoffel. Switzerland's first swimming medal of Nanjing 2014. She only swims backstroke and fly. But the champion, a real sprinter, 17-year-old Rozaliya NASRETDINOVA. She started well in the preliminaries with a sub 27-second swim. She did that in the semi-finals as well, and has now posted the fastest ever time by a junior to win gold in Nanjing 2014. A genuine sprinter, and she's got the gold medal in China to prove it. For the national anthem of the Russian Federation. Your champion, a particularly proud young lady from the Russian Federation, NASRETDINOVA, so impressive. She claimed gold ahead of STOFFEL and GOVEJSEK of Slovenia, all-European rostrum.
Well, if you look back at that race, you know, you can clearly see that on her finish, she absolutely nailed it. And because of that, although the race was quite close, she still managed to get a 0.4 deficit on the silver medal. So that just amplifies that the starts and finishes are so important in the 50-meter race.
Switzerland, their first medal in the pool at Nanjing 2014. Similarly for Slovenia, with a fifth gold for Russia. Now on to two highly competitive semi-finals for the men's 50-meter fly. Another sprint event. Philip Chopin of Russia and Alexander Sadovnikov both go for the Russian Federation. Yuhishin in the pool again. Josh Stein in the pool again. Some incredibly impressive young swimmers. Hoping to post a time that'll see them compete for the gold, silver and bronze medals come the men's 50-meter fly final. Top eight times across the 16 competitors will do battle over these respective semi-finals to advance to that gold medal race.
Ladies and gentlemen, the
These are the swimmers who will do battle for the top times that they hope to achieve to see them through comfortably to the men's 50 fly final.
All eyes have got to be on this man, Yu Hixin, who took out the 53 gold, so very powerful swimmer.
Very good lane one for the Russian Federation, which is a 16-year-old based in St. Petersburg, Philip Shofin. Josh Stein goes for South Africa in lane two. Jonas Sultans of Latvia goes in three. And the People's Republic of China, a gold medalist already in session eight, looking to make yet another individual final. Yu Hixin. Alexander Sudovnikov, this 17-year-old, is real power in the pool. And Lithuania's Povilas Strasdash goes in lane six. Argentina's Santiago Grassi goes in lane seven. And Norbert Csabo of Hungary will round out the lane draw in eight.
Well, the race will be on in the center lanes, but look, the power from Yu Hixin is just unbelievable, and his start is something quite phenomenal.
There is a man who can challenge him, though. It's Alexander Sudovnikov. Left arm just a little higher than his right in the stroke, but it looks immaculate from our viewpoint. Getting off to a superb start once more. Yu Hixin out on his outside. Sudovnikov, not the first up out of the pool, and Yu straight into his stroke, but Sudovnikov and Yu matching each other and streaking ahead of the other competitors over this distance. One length of this Olympic pool. It's the 50-meter fly first semi-final, and Yu Hixin is going to take it ahead of Sudovnikov. He's coming in very quickly. He needs to go. Oh, between strokes, he only just managed to hit the wall first. Sudovnikov timed it better with his strokes. Yu may have been ahead, but he did not get his stroke right. 24.03, that's a quick time as he crashes into the wall just ahead of Sudovnikov.
I think he did get a bit lucky on that finish, as you said, and these sorts of things have to be done to perfection in that final if you want to be any contention for that gold medal. But he's going to look back, he's going to see that, something to work on.
I think he was just a little rushed in trying to get up out of the water and into his stroke, because that's where his real power lies. He doesn't streamline as well as some of the other swimmers, but he's done enough in the stroke, separated by 6/100ths of a second. What a final await, especially if we can get one of the other top swimmers from semi-final two to place between these two. So Sudovnikov and Yu, China and Russia, will do battle once more. The start list for the second semi-final, the men's 50 fly. Sasha Subarski will go for Austria in one. But Dylan Carter and Li Chuhao are the two swimmers you'll be watching most closely, no doubt. They go in lanes four and five of the second semi-final.
Well, Dylan Carter, he is the technician when it comes to 50 butterfly. But he would have seen what was in that first semi-final, and he's going to need to make a good response to put himself in a nice lane for that final.
This is Dylan Carter's best event, arguably, and this is where you get a sense of his superb technique. Austria's Sasha Subarski goes in one, though. Norwegian swimmer Armin Porovic goes in two. 18-year-old from Oslo. The Estonian swimmer, Daniel Zaitsev, only 16 years old, but a very strong closer over 50. Trinidad and Tobago, already a bronze medal in the pool in session eight. Dylan Carter in the free, now to his strongest stroke, the 50 fly semi-final. Li Chuhao, the 15-year-old who banned his parents from coming to the natatorium last night. In session six, as he went on to win the 100 fly gold. Matheus Hursen of the Netherlands goes in six. Australia's Kyle Chalmers, 24-second swimmer at his best over this distance. The Australian senior silver medalist over this distance goes in seven. Chad Idenson of Zimbabwe, also relatively quick, can dip below 25 seconds. And the men's 50 fly goes in eight.
Well, Li Chuhao gets very nervous when his parents are watching him swim, which is why they weren't there. But in this case, the 50 fly, there's not much time to get too nervous.
Not much time at all. Might be champion over the 100 fly. And he's got to put in a good start. And he's got the technically superb Carter in lane four, just on his inside. Carter showing his class from the start. A very good start as well for Idenson of Zimbabwe out in lane eight, but hasn't got enough on the stroke. Carter already looking immaculate in the pool. A nice high technique. Oh, he's so flat. Look at the shoulders moving over. He's breathing on every third stroke. He is looking so comfortable. He's not aware of where the other swimmers are, though. But Dylan Carter, a few swimmers closing on him. He should get to the line first. And he does indeed, ahead of course. And Lee Tuhao. Just looked like he struggled to get into the stroke that he found in the 100 fly final. Well, Dylan Carter, 24.04. He'll take that and he'll march on.
So we've got three swimmers sitting on that 24.0 mark headed for that final. So those three center lanes for that test of medal contention final is going to be incredible.
It really is going to be incredible. Daniel Zaitsev finishing very strongly for Estonia as well. He's such an impressive closer, is this young Estonian swimmer, barely 16. And Zaitsev finishes third behind Hursen of the Netherlands and indeed the class act, as it were, Dylan Carter of Trinidad and Tobago. Lee Tuhao, well, has he done enough to make the final? I think he has. 24-4-1. Borovic himself might even sneak into the final, the Norwegian. Confirmation. And Norway's Porovic does make the final. Lee Tuhao and Yu Heshin will represent China. But what a battle deluxe awaits in the men's fly final. Carter, Sadovnikov and Yu Heshin all alongside one another in the center lanes. That is going to be titanic. This is the start list for a most eagerly anticipated event, the women's 200-meter freestyle. And again, a race in which any one of at least six swimmers could take the top two spots. A silver medal in the medley relay. Amelia Moore of Great Britain goes in one. Amy Matsuo of Australia goes in lane two. Two relay bronze medals already, and eager to make up for a disappointment of missing a medal in the women's 100. Brianna Throssell, her compatriot, goes in three. The two Chinese swimmers will go alongside the two Australians. Shen Duo, three gold medals in three events for the People's Republic of China. And she is looking to augment her 100 free title with a 200 free title. Tu Yuhan goes in five for China. The bronze medalist over the 100. Daria Ulgaeva of Russia goes in six. Michel Tiracci of Italy goes in lane seven. Well, Hong Kong, China's 16-year-old Siobhan Hoi goes in lane eight. She's already got two silver medalists, and she took one of those silvers from the outside lane.
Well, she'd have to be the dark horse there in lane eight. She's swum impressively in her 100 to come out in the outside lane. But then again, China in the middle with Australia and with the two Aussies in two and three as well. It's going to be a great race.
This is going to be a phenomenal race. Again, such a build-up. It's a sense of revenge for Matsuo in particular. Throssell would just love to get something other than a bronze medal, I would suggest. The Chinese swimmers looking for nothing more, nothing less than gold and silver. And into this women's 200-meter final, Shen Duo not getting off to the most prolific start, but Tuo Yuhan looking very good. I would suggest, though, that the best of the swimmers currently is out in lane eight. Siobhan Hoi, again, Hong Kong, China. We know she's capable of claiming a medal from the outside lane. She is looking superb after the first 50, but Shen Duo comes into her own. And I think Shen Duo, she does touch just ahead of Tuo, her compatriot, and Hoi. Could they make it China, China, and Hong Kong, China, all on the podium once more?
Well, the leaders here right now, Hong Kong and China, were the strongest swimmers in the 100 freestyle, so we can expect they will be out fast in this first leg. But ending that to her, very strong on the back end. Same with Brianna Throssell and obviously the Russian in lane six, Malakheva.
And while Metzwa certainly has a very strong close, she left it too late in the 100. And might she have done the same here in the 200? It's still two ahead of Shin. And now it's Hoi who is just closing down that advantage of the Chinese swimmers. Trying to breathe every third stroke, and she's well aware of what's happening on her inside. But at the moment, it's China looking good for gold and silver. I think Hoi, the only swimmer currently that looks like she's got a chance of even catching over the final 50. This is going to be almost certainly the last 50 sprint between the two Chinese swimmers to see who takes gold and who takes the silver.
Well, here come the Aussies up on lane three. Brianna Throssell is making a move, but is it too late? And at the moment, Shen Juo has put on the accelerator, and she's going for the wall.
Hoi with a poor turn for Hong Kong, China, and Brianna Throssell is pushing up for a bronze medal position. At the moment, though, it is Shen Duo looking for her fourth gold medal in just four events for the People's Republic of China to bring home what will be another Chinese 1-2. It is Shen Duo with their fourth individual, or second individual, and fourth gold medal overall for the People's Republic of China. It's Tu Yuhan, a bronze medalist over the 100, claims silver now for the People's Republic of China. Indeed, the third place finish for Australia's Brianna Throssell, her fourth bronze medal of these championships.
Well, 156.1, that is a phenomenal time for a junior. And I mean, we haven't seen the best. I think there's a lot more to come from these guys, but the whole field, incredible field, incredible swim, but the Chinese outclassed them all tonight.
Well, to not even notice a swim from somebody like Amelia Morn, who's got such a strong close, and Amy Matsua not realistically being in contention, with Hoi placing sixth overall, you get a sense of just how strong these two Chinese swimmers were. Tu and Shen to take it. She's entered four events. She's got four gold medals, and that is superb. She is the swimmer that has made arguably the most waves, most impressive waves of Nanjing 2014. It was one swimmer who stuck her hand up to be counted. It is Shen Duo, the champion, ahead of her compatriot Brianna Throssell of Australia for the fourth bronze medal of Nanjing 2014. Men's 50 backstroke was always going to be a grudge swim of sorts between two men who dead heated in the men's 100 backstroke, and indeed a man with the most impressive credentials in backstroke who failed to medal in the 100. They would end 1, 2, and 3, and in the end it was Russia who were left celebrating. This is the victory ceremony for the men's 50 meter backstroke.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's 50 meter backstroke. 与日本先生们第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会男子50米仰泳颁奖仪式现在开始. Please welcome the medalists. 欢迎获奖运动员入场.
These are your medalists. Apostolos CHRISTOU of Greece. First up, the champion RYLOV. Sandwiched in between CHRISTOU of Greece and indeed the bronze medal winner of Italy, Simone SABBIONI. Medals will be presented by Mr. Lambos V. Nikolaou, the International Olympic Committee member from Greece.
Accompanied by Madame Nikolaou,
after claiming gold in the men's 100 meter backstroke and taking silver in the men's 4x100 freestyle relay. Simone Sabbioni now has a collection of all the medals, a gold, silver, and now a bronze after finishing third in the men's 50 meter backstroke. It was a solid enough swim once he was in the pool, but it was his start that let him down, and over one length of an Olympic pool, it's not a realistic chance of making up too much ground, too much in the water, particularly against swimmers of the caliber of RYLOV and CHRISTOU. Looking to medal after the disappointment of missing out on a medal and the men's 100 backstroke. The Greek swimmer, Apostolos Christou, does get a medal. Perhaps not the colour he wanted, but a medal nonetheless after a second place finish in the men's 50 metre backstroke. Silver medalist. Over the shortest distance for the men's backstroke. But after claiming 100 meter backstroke gold in a dead heat with the man who finished with the bronze medal in this race, Simone Sabbioni, Evgeny RYLOV can claim to be the best young backstroker in the world. He's done the 50 and 100 double. Was the fastest time.
Well, that's it. He got everything right in that race, and that was the most important key. Those two other guys, Sabbioni and Christou, just couldn't quite catch him on that last 5 meters and had a great finish and really dominated the field.
He came into session eight looking for two gold medals. One in this event, the 50 backstroke, and the other in the final event of the evening, the medley relay final. Well, he's achieved half of that. Fastest time ever by a junior, over one length of the pool, swimming backstroke, a 25.09. He's within a second of the senior world record. Thoroughly impressive for the diminutive Russian Federation swimmer, Evgeny RYLOV, your champion of the men's 50-meter backstroke. Silver medalist Apostolos Christou has some consolation from Nanjing 2014, and Simone Sabbioni with a bronze medal to complete his collection.
Well, he may not have the height of the other competitors, but he has certainly got the technique and the power. This gentleman has displayed some incredible backstroke, and no doubt he's looking forward to the 4x1 medley relay coming up next.
Women's 100 meter breaststroke was practically a foregone conclusion before the race had even started. The gold medal winner would be Ruta MEILUTYTE of Lithuania. The reigning world champion, reigning Olympic champion, the current world record holder over this distance. And after a very comfortable gold in the 50 meter breaststroke, expected to complete the double, Ruta MEILUTYTE of Lithuania did not disappoint. This is the women's 100-meter breaststroke victory ceremony. Three young women put in three thoroughly impressive swims to claim gold, silver, and bronze in the two lengths of this Olympic pool in the women's 100 meter breaststroke. MEILUTYTE, who will receive her gold medal from Pierre-Olivier Becker-Vuhier of Belgium. Member of the International Olympic Committee. Bronze medal for this young swimmer from the Ukraine, Anastasiya MALYAVINA. MALYAVINA, a bronze medal for the Ukraine. Ukraine claimed the very first gold medal in the pool. In session two, to conclude day one, a certain young man named Romanchuk claimed the gold in the men's 400 freestyle. Adding to her rising star, a bronze in the women's 100 meter breaststroke for Anastasiya MALYAVINA. Representing People's Republic of China, more expectation on the shoulders of the crowd favorite, 17-year-old Hyun. Gold in the women's 4x100 medley relay, where she swam superbly well. The quickest breaststroke leg in that relay. But that's, I would suggest, only because MEILUTYTE was not swimming in that relay for Lithuania. A silver medal behind a great champion. Just completing more and more impressive international medal hauls. Ruta MEILUTYTE of Lithuania. It's a breaststroke of yourself, Christian. You look at what she continues to do. Officially, this is the fastest time by a junior, but she holds the world record at over a second faster than the time she swam to win gold tonight.
Well, that's it. She's phenomenal, and what she's achieved at such a young age is so inspirational, so admirable. But, you know, as I said, a lot of athletes go a lot of their career hoping to snatch that Olympic gold, but she's already done it.
Really summing up what youth Olympic gold means to her after winning Olympic gold in London 2 years ago. And now for the second time in the Nanjing Olympic Sports Internet Auditorium, Lithuania's national anthem. The champions, silver and bronze, all on the podium. Ruta MEILUTYTE of Lithuania, a champion once more, has completed the 15-100 breaststroke double. MALYAVINA of Ukraine taking the bronze, and Hyun of China with the silver.
True champion, MEILUTYTE. You know, I can't stop talking about her. She's so dynamic, she's so strong, and she's so focused too. You know, to have that real eye on the prize at such a young age, she's very sorted, she's very athletic, she's very determined, and she's here once again on the podium, taking another gold medal.
It's a complete dedication. It sums up her character, and success is translated in the pool. Start list now for the men's 4x100 medley relay, the final event of session 8. Spain, France, South Africa, Russian Federation, Germany, Australia, Japan, and the United States will battle it out for another gold medal. The real battle surely would have to be between the Russian Federation and Germany. Sam Ramsamy of South Africa, long-time servant, the man who drove Olympic sport so long in South Africa, is sitting alongside Thomas Bach, the International Olympic Committee president. Lithuanian fans are still in very good cheer after the success of MEILUTYTE's second gold medal. China not involved in this 4x100 medley relay final. There are a few fans who slowly filed out of the Olympic Sports Center Natatorium, not quite as full as it was for the individual finals, but indeed now another team final. And the Russian Federation looking for a third success in session 8 of the swimming competition at Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games. If they do claim gold in this race, they will move ahead of China into top spots in the gold medal hall. This will be their third gold of the night. And indeed. Spain go in lane one. Guillermo Sanchez, Gonzalo Garazo Barbero, Juan Pablo Marin Sanchez, and Marc Vivasseguer. For France, Geoffrey Mathieu, Jean Decos, Guillaume Laure, and Raiti de Force will go in lane two. South Africa, represented by Chris Reed, Jared Krause, Josh Stein, and Brent Sudoki. Russian Federation, are they the champions elect? Evgeny RYLOV, Anton CHUPKOV, Alexander Sadovnikov, and indeed Philip Chopin. But alongside them, the nearest challengers surely Germany, Marek Ulrich, Maximilian Pilger, and then the incredibly impressive fly specialist Alexander Kunert, and the freestyler Damien Wierling will finish. Australia represented by Nick Grunewald, Grayson Bell, Nicholas Brown, and Kyle Chalmers will be expected to bring it home. And in lane seven, Japan, represented by Koki Tsunifuka, Yuta Sato, Yuda Yamada, and the 200-meter breaststroke champion, Ippei WATANABE. The United States of America have withdrawn and will not represent the Stars and Stripes in lane eight.
Expect Russia to be off to a flying start here with Evgeny RYLOV, who's just fresh off his 50-meter gold in backstroke. He'll enter after that with Anton CHUPKOV, who is the breaststroke champion. So Russian Federation are going to be tough to beat in this first 200.
Well, they lay it down. Germany will come over fast, but Russia may very well have an unassailable lead after the first 200. This is the men's 4x100 medley relay final, and an immediate reaction from RYLOV. 0.52, very quick into it. Grunewald with a really good start for Australia, but we're already just on its outside as the Russian Federation's RYLOV looking so solid down that central lane in four. The real battle is going to be on for all the nations swimming alongside the Russian Federation to try to hold on for dear life, as it were. Germany holding on for now. Australia and South Africa likely to battle for the bronze medal position here. And Chris Reed is tucked behind Australia's Nick Grunewald. But certainly Marek Ulrich is holding on for Germany in second position. As both Australia and South Africa trying to battle into the bronze medal spot. But certainly an enormous lead been built up by the men's 100-meter backstroke champion, the men's 50-meter backstroke champion, CHUPKOV of Russia. We need to make sure, of course, RYLOV of Russia, rather. CHUPKOV now into the pool for the Russians, the 100-meter breaststroke champion. And it must be mentioned that China are not swimming in this final, quite simply because in the preliminaries, they got the changeovers wrong. Disqualified for the second time in the relays of Nanjing 2014. It's so important to make sure you change overs, you don't jump the gun. But at the moment, Russian Federation dominating in the early stages, as we expected them to do, with the champions in the backstroke and indeed breaststroke over 100 meters, swimming the first two legs for the Russian Federation. Australia looking very good through Grayson Bell. He's just done nearly 29 seconds over the first 50 and looking very solid to finish and maybe even put Australia into silver medal contention here. Grayson Bell, this is a superb swim from the Australian. And Chad Krause is trying to get up on the outside shoulder of Max Pilger of Germany. Now, Pilger just going ahead now of Bell. He looked to take it a little too hard, perhaps fading slightly in the closing stages. Into the pool now for the Russian Federation is Alexander Sadovnikov, the fly specialist.
Well, this is where Russia are seemingly weak, but at the moment they've got that great lead, and I can't see them shortening up too soon. But South Africa on their right and Germany on their left, they're going to have to really stick in there if they want to see a chance in that final freestyle leg.
Three medals up for grabs, four teams in contention. Russian Federation looking well set for gold here. With less than 150 meters to swim, Sadovnikov into his final 30-odd meters of his leg of this medley relay. It is first 100 meters of backstroke, 100 meters of breaststroke, 100 meters of butterfly, and the final leg freestyle. Philip Chopin will take it home for the Russian Federation. Just fading a little here, Kunert for Germany, I think doing too much in Australia, looking so good through Nicholas Brown, whose father was an Olympian, Ian Brown. Kyle Chalmers into the pool for Australia, who look well set for a medal, it could even be silver. South Africa as well, through Josh Stein, making up some good ground, to Doki in the pool for South Africa, but Philip Schuppin does not look like he's going to be caught for the Russian Federation. It is certainly going to be a third gold medal for the Russian Federation in session eight, barring a miracle of sorts.
Well, South Africa and Australia battling out for that bronze medal. It is looking very close, and I think Australia might have the upper hand on South Africa after that turn.
22 seconds from Damian Vierling over the first 50. He is catching Philip Schuppin, and he is catching him at a remarkable rate. It's not going to be enough for gold, but it's certainly enough to secure the silver. South Africa look like they're set to claim the... It's Australia, rather, look set for the bronze medal. South Africa, after some good work by Josh Stein in the third leg, can't find their way to the bronze medal. Australia settled for a bronze medal. Germany second, with Vierling closing so impressively fast. A 48.69 for Damian Vierling, but still not enough to catch Philip Schuppin, who went over 50 seconds. Well, after Rylov and Chupkov had taken it out so quickly for the Russian Federation. Gold is always on the cards, and they've not disappointed. A 3.38.02 for the Russian Federation, their third gold medal of Session 8 in the pool.
Well, some of those splits were phenomenal. Russian Federation, Rylov with a 54.3, Chupkov with a 1.003 in that 100 breaststroke, Sadnikov with a 53.2, and Schuppin with a solid 50.09. What a great team.
Solid team. The changeovers were good. They didn't jump the gun. They were very deliberate about the changeovers. And when you have the 100-meter backstroke champion going first, Rylov, Chupkov, the 100-meter breaststroke champion, going in your second leg, and Sadovnikov is well set for a 50-fly medal. Well, I tell you, you've got such a strong start. Schuppin, though, closing it out for the Russian Federation. That unassailable lead had been built up. In the end, though, so solid for the Russian Federation, tasting more success. Three gold medals on the night. After the individual success of NASRETDINOVA in the women's 50 fly, and RYLOV managing to claim the men's 50 back, it's helped the Russian Federation to a third gold medal in session eight. They finish ahead of Germany, who claim silver, and Australia settle for the bronze. When Shinduo and Tu Yuhan lined up alongside one another in lanes 4 and 5, the People's Republic of China anticipated another gold-silver finish. Shinduo, three gold medals in three events coming into this, her fourth event, after swimming to women's 100-meter free gold. Swam comfortably to women's 200-meter free gold. Four events, four gold medals for Shinduo. He's been arguably the most impressive swimmer of these championships in terms of sheer domination in her respective events. Women's 200 meter freestyle victory ceremony is upon us. People's Republic of China having done the 1-2. Rihanna Throssell of Australia collecting her fourth medal of Nanjing 2014. Nigeria, International Olympic Committee member, presents gold, silver, and bronze medals. After winning bronze in the women's 4x100 medley relay, then bronze in the mixed 4x100 freestyle relay, and then bronze in the women's 200 fly, Rihanna Throssell has her fourth bronze medal at Nanjing 2014 Youth Olympic Games, with bronze in the women's 200 meter freestyle. Such a delight, always a smile on the face.
Well, she swam that race incredibly well. She pulled on the back end. The Chinese went out so strong, and to really pull it back in that last 50 was a great effort from Throssell.
And really did need to make up some work. Amelia Morn of Great Britain was closing fast. Amy Mutzel with a strong finish needed to close fast. And Siobhan Hoy was desperately trying to hold on for the bronze medal position. Throssell stole it from the other three swimmers. But after the first 50, it looked like it was going to be a race between the two Chinese swimmers to see who would end up with gold and who would end up with silver. In the end, the younger of the two, Zhu Yuhan, would finish with the silver medal. She has a collection now, two golds in the relays, a bronze as well from the 100 free. And now a silver in the women's 200 free. But a most popular champion, 17-year-old Shen Duo from the host nation, the People's Republic of China.
Well, she's such an impressive swimmer. There's not too many freestyles out there that can take the 100 meters and 200 meters double these days. It's such a different race, but that sheer power, that efficiency, and that endurance was what gave her the win tonight.
Four events and four gold medals. It's about knowing your strengths, sticking to them. She is focused, she's determined, and as a result, she is the most decorated swimmer of Nanjing 2014. Once more, the national anthem of the People's Republic of China. In the auditorium. a worthy champion, the most successful individual swimmer of Nanjing 2014 thus far. A warm embrace for the bronze medalist, Brianna Throssell, and indeed her compatriot, Chu Yuhan. China 1-2, Australia 3rd. An impressive swim from Throssell, finishing strong. Wonderful legacy that's been left in the People's Republic of China following the success of the 2008 Beijing Olympic Games. Legacy continuing with some impressive swimmers coming through. Development, very much an aspect of youth identification from the early stages, leading to the success in the pool that we've seen in Nanjing 2014.
These two girls certainly putting Chinese freestyle swimming in a very good position for the future. And with only 2 years away, we could see these girls on the senior level in Rio in 2016.
We expect Rio 2016 is going to be a breakthrough major senior international event for a few young men and women who've impressed throughout the 8 sessions of Nanjing's 2014 swimming competition thus far. Eight lengths of the pool, each swimmer expected to do 2, have a first backstroke, then breaststroke, then butterfly, and then freestyle to bring it home. The men's 4x100m medley relay final. 7 nations contesting the gold medal. And there was only one that we were focused on from the start, the Russian Federation. RYLOV and CHUPKOV, champions over 100 meters in their respective strokes. Back and breast. Before Sadovnikov took to the pool for the fly leg. And Philip Chopin closed it out. A solid enough freestyle leg to end. Russian Federation, a 3rd gold medal of Session 8. This is the victory ceremony for the men's 4x100 medley relay.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for the men's 400 meter medley relay. 女士们、先生们，第二届夏季青年奥林匹克运动会男子四乘一百米混合泳接力颁奖仪式现在开始。 So please welcome the medalists. 欢迎获奖运动员入场。
12 young medalists. Four will leave with bronze around their neck. Four will leave with silver around their neck. But only four will leave with gold medals around their necks. Respective medals, 12 in total, for the men's 4x100 meter medley relay. Australian team. Grunewald took it out very nicely for Australia. You can see the sense of delight from these young men. Grayson Bell swimming the breaststroke leg. Nicholas Brown really, when South Africa were challenging for the bronze medal, Nicholas Brown made a real difference in the pool as he battled with Josh Stain. Held him off. And then Carl Chalmers to bring it home. Going below 50 seconds. Sub 50. And the second fastest to close with a 49.09.
Australia really needed that 49.0 to take over from South Africa to clinch that bronze. But these boys put in a great effort. You know, it's tough under the circumstances. They've really got a lift. But for Germany and Russian, for Germany and Russia, they were just too strong.
There were a question mark or two over the Germans' lead-off legs. Marek Ulrich and Max Pilger. When Kuhnert took to the pool for the fly leg, and indeed when Damian Wierling was in the pool for the freestyle, knew there would be a comeback of sorts from Germany. Whether or not Russia and Federation have built up a significant enough lead to prove unassailable for the Germans was always going to be the question that needed to be asked after the first 150, 200 metres, certainly. But your silver medalists, Marek Ulrich, Max Pilger, Alexander Kuhnert and Damian Wierling, who swam the fastest closing leg of the men's 4x100 medley relay, to guarantee silver for Germany. But your champions are from the Russian Federation. RYLOV, CHUPKOV, Sadovnikov and Shopin. Evgeny RYLOV with his third gold medal of Nanjing 2014 after claiming the 50 and 100 backstroke double. And now a relay gold medal in the men's 4x100 medley relay. Anton CHUPKOV His second gold medal after a bronze in the breaststroke over 200 meters. He won the men's 100 breaststroke. And now the second gold medal for him. Sadovnikov, a silver in the 100 fly, set for a medal in the 50, but now a gold in the relay. And indeed, Filip Chopin with his first gold medal of Nanjing 2014. Four proud young men who have secured the Russian Federation's third gold medal on session 8 of the swimming competition. The last of the seven finals for session 8. Now, for the Russian anthem. Another sumptuous display of impressive swimming from these young men.
Ladies and gentlemen, the youth Olympics medalist,
the Russian Federation augmenting their gold medal haul with not only individual displays, but with a fine team effort to conclude session 8. They are your champions of the men's 4x100 medley relay. Germany finished with silver and Australia claimed bronze. Federation team staying around in support, and indeed NASRETDINOVA, who gave Russia their first gold medal of the night with top spot in the women's 50 fly, cheering on her compatriots, cheering on her teammates, and again the camaraderie continues. Australians going over to congratulate the German swimmers and indeed the Russian champions. In real sense of what the Youth Olympics is about, and indeed the sense of Olympism. And that concludes a fine display of swimming on day 4.